run.
It has been very stormy weather and the school roof is leaking.
How can we raise the money to fix the school roof?
We could have a fun run.
What's a funny run?
It's a day for picnics and giving money to see people run. And the more money you give, the further they run.
Good idea, Daddy Pig. How far can you run?
What? Well, I can run as far as you like.
But, Daddy, you can hardly run at all.
Nonsense. I'm an expert at running.
Good. Does anyone else want to run?
No, thank you.
But I'll give money to see Daddy Pig run.
Me too.
And me.
Excellent. Thank you, Daddy Pig.
Peppa and her family are eating spaghetti.
Delicious. Is there any more spaghetti?
Daddy Pig, you've already had 3 helpings.
Eating gives me energy. And I need energy for my fun run.
You also need to practice running.
What if I practice eating today, then practice running tomorrow?
No, Daddy. You need to practice running now.
Oh.
Come on, Daddy. Race you.
This is easy.
It is easy to run downhill. It is hard to run uphill.
I don't think I should have eaten so much spaghetti.
It is the day of the fun run. Madame Gazelle has a chart to show how far Daddy Pig must run.
If Daddy Pig can run to here...
The supermarket.
Then to here...
My granddad's garage.
And all the way to here...
Windy Castle.
Then we'll have enough money to fix the school roof.
I'll do it now. Ready, steady, go! I did it! Now we can have the picnic.
Silly Daddy. That's just a drawing.
Yes. Now you must run to the real Windy Castle.
Oh.
Ready, steady, go.
Hooray!
Come on, Daddy Pig! You can make it!
The school bus has made it to Windy Castle. Now everyone can enjoy the picnic.
Water! Water!
What a lovely hot day! And such a relaxing way to raise money, too.
Water! Water!
Daddy Pig has reached the supermarket. All the running has made him very thirsty.
Let's look through the telescope.
I can see Daddy.
The telescope makes everything look closer.
Oh, he's not going very fast.
Daddy Pig has arrived at Granddad Dog's garage.
That's it. I can't go on.
Daddy has stopped.
Oh.
You look rather hot. You need something to cool you down and give you energy. Have an ice lolly.
Thank you, Granddad Dog. That's nice. Ah, a wasp. Shoo, shoo. Get away, you little pest.
The wasp wants to share Daddy Pig's ice lolly.
No! This is my lolly.
Daddy started running again. Really fast.
Hooray!
Ah, get off! Get off!
You can stop now, Daddy Pig. We have enough money to fix the school roof.
Ah!
Daddy Pig has lost the wasp.
Well done, Daddy Pig. All that extra running means we've got enough money for a new school bus, too.
Thank you, Daddy Pig.
You're most welcome.
Washing.
Daddy Pig is doing the washing this morning.
Daddy, what's that shirt?
It's my football shirt.
Daddy's playing football this afternoon.
Ooh.
But first, I have to go to work. See you later. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Poor Daddy. Having to go to work.
Oh, poor. Poor Daddy.
Come on, let's play.
Yes, let's play.
Peppa loves jumping up and down in muddy puddles. George loves jumping up and down in muddy puddles. Mummy Pig loves jumping up and down in muddy puddles. Oh, dear.
Mummy, we splashed Daddy's football shirt with mud.
Oh, don't worry. We'll just wash it. It'll be washed in no time, and Daddy won't know it was ever muddy. Let's find some more things to put in the machine.
Oh, my dress is a bit muddy.
Mummy Pig and George have found more things to wash.
Very good, George. We put the clothes in here, and then we switch it on.
The washing machine is filling up with hot, soapy water.
Splosh, 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 splosh.
The washing machine is making the whole room shake.
Oh, Peppa, where's your dress?
I'm washing it.
What? Oh, no.
Look, Mummy. My red dress is all nice and clean.
Yes, Peppa. But look what it's done to everything else.
Oh, dear. Peppa's red dress has made all the white clothes pink.
Pink isn't a very good colour for a football shirt.
Ooh.
Daddy Pig is home from work.
Hello, everyone.
Hello, Daddy.
Daddy Pig, we've got a bit of a problem and,
Tell me later, Mummy Pig. I've got to get ready for football. Now, where's my football shirt?
Here.
Don't be silly, Peppa. That's one of Mummy's dresses. It's pink.
No, Daddy. It's your football shirt.
It got a bit muddy.
So we washed it.
And it all went a bit wrong. Sorry, Daddy.
But I can't wear a pink football shirt.
Why not, Daddy? Pink is a lovely colour.
Hmm. What do you think, George?
Yuck.
George does not like pink. Here are Daddy Pig's friends, Mr. Bull, Mr. Rabbit, Mr. Pony and Mr. Zebra.
Moo! Is Daddy Pig coming out to play?
He'll just be a moment.
My team are in white. I need a white shirt.
But, Daddy, you have a white shirt. Just take off your jacket. See?
Fantastic! Thank you, Peppa. Hello, everyone.
Hello, Daddy Pig.
Like your shirt.
Very smart.
Thank you. Come on, let's play football.
Yes!
Go!
Hooray!
Hooray!
Daddy, you've made your shirt all muddy.
Of course, Peppa. Football shirts are meant to be muddy.
Daddy Pig loves playing football. Everyone loves playing football, especially when it's muddy.
The library.
It is bedtime.
Good night, Peppa. Good night, George.
Can I have a story, please?
Okay. I'll read you the Red Monkey book.
But we always have that one. The red monkey has a bath, cleans his teeth and goes to sleep.
Yes, that is what happens.
Can we choose another story? The blue tiger, the green spider, the orange penguin. Oh, what's this one?
The Wonderful World of Concrete.
I've been looking for that.
Is it your book, Daddy?
It's a book I borrowed from the library.
What's a library?
It's a place you borrow books from. And when you've finished reading them, you take them back.
But Daddy Pig has forgotten to take this book back.
I have had it for rather a long time.
Never mind. You can take it back tomorrow. But now it's bedtime.
After Daddy reads this story.
It's not much of a story, Peppa.
Please read it, Daddy.
Okay. The Wonderful World of Concrete. Concrete is a construction material composed of sand, water, and chemical admixtures. Chapter 1. Sand.
Peppa, George, and Mummy Pig have fallen asleep. It is morning. Peppa and her family have come to the library.
Wow! What a lot of books!
Shh! Peppa, you must be quiet in the library.
Why?
Because people come here to read and to be quiet.
Next, please!
Miss Rabbit is the librarian.
Hello, Mummy Pig. Are you returning these books?
Yes, Miss Rabbit.
Right you are.
Why is the computer beeping?
It's checking to see that you haven't been naughty and borrowed the book for too long.
I may have borrowed this book for a bit too long. Oh,
don't worry, Daddy Pig. It can't be that bad. Gosh! Daddy Pig, you've had this book out for 10 years.
Naughty Daddy.
Sorry, Miss Rabbit.
That's all right. Now you can borrow another book.
Miss Rabbit, can George and I borrow a book, please?
Yes. The children's section is over here.
Oh, look. Fairies, flowers. Pretty dresses.
Hello, Peppa.
Oh, hello, Danny.
I'm borrowing a book about football.
Hello, Peppa.
Hello, Susie.
I've got a book about nurses.
George has chosen a book about dinosaurs.
Dinosaur.
Look what I found. Further Adventures in the World of Concrete.
Here's a red monkey book.
Not the red monkey book. It's boring.
But this is a different story. It might be more fun.
I bet it's not.
Once upon a time, there was a red monkey.
He had a bath, cleaned his teeth and went to bed.
No, he jumped in a space rocket and went to the moon.
Ooh.
He had a picnic with a dinosaur, swam under the sea and climbed the highest mountain. That was a busy day. The end.
Wow! Read it again.
We can borrow it and read it at home, Peppa.
But I was going to choose this book or this one.
You can take 3 books home if you want, Peppa.
Yippee!
But you must remember to bring them back on time.
Yes, Miss Rabbit.
And you must remember to bring your book back too, Daddy Pig.
I'll make sure Daddy remembers.
Yes, Peppa. I'm sure you will. Ho, ho!
Camping holiday.
Peppa's family are on holiday in their camper van.
Good morning, my little piggies.
Good morning, Daddy Pig.
I love camping.
Since we're in the countryside, I thought we could spend the day looking at nature.
Good idea, Mummy Pig. Let's watch a nature program.
One of the wonders of nature, birds.
How lovely. Shush, shush, little birdie. We can't hear our TV.
Oh, Daddy Pig, there's no point being on a camping holiday and just watching TV. We can do that at home.
Good thinking, Mummy Pig.
There are lots of fun places we can visit. There's Tree World.
What's Tree World?
Tree World is a big forest full of trees.
It sounds a bit boring.
Or there's Potato City.
What's Potato City?
There's a tour of the potato fields ending with a potato tasting.
Sounds interesting.
Or there's Duckland.
What's Duckland?
It's a wide river full of ducks.
Duckland. Let's go to Duckland.
Peppa and George love ducks.
How do we get to Duckland?
The camper van can guide us.
Hello. Where are we going today?
Duckland, please.
Follow the road ahead in a straight line.
We're going to Duckland in a camper van.
Welcome to Duckland. How many tickets, please?
Two adults and two children.
Enjoy the ducks!
Where are the ducks?
Maybe they're on holiday.
Let's have our picnic lunch. The ducks always turn up
when we have picnics.
Peppa and George love picnics.
Look, it's the ducks. Stop, Daddy. We need bread for the ducks.
All right.
Hello, Mrs. Duck.
Here come more ducks.
All their brothers and sisters are here.
And here come more ducks.
It's the Granny and Grandpa ducks.
And here are all the aunties and uncles.
Oh, that's the last of our picnic gone.
Ducks, say thank you to Daddy Pig.
Ho, ho. You're most welcome.
I love Duckland.
It is time to go home.
I wonder what's the shortest way home?
Drive straight ahead into the river.
Oh, are you sure?
Yes. Drive into the river.
But we can't drive in the river.
Yes. It's talking nonsense.
Please press the blue button.
The camper van is driving into the river.
Our camper van has turned into a boat.
I wasn't quite expecting that.
Welcome to the car of the future.
Look, it's Grandad Dog and Danny Dog.
Ahoy there, Daddy Pig.
Ahoy there.
Beep, beep. Sailing on the river in the camper van.
Drive up the next hill. You have reached your destination.
We're home.
Thank you for a lovely holiday, Mrs. Campervan.
Ho, ho, you're most welcome.
It's nice going on holiday, but it's nicer to be back in our own little house.
Good night, my little piggies.
Good night. The train ride.
Today, Peppa and her friends are going on a train ride. Mr. Rabbit is the station master.
How many tickets?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 child tickets and 1 teacher ticket, please. Now, children, do not lose these tickets.
Can I see your tickets, please?
I've lost my ticket.
Oh, dear Pedro, you must be more careful.
There's your ticket.
Oh, try not to lose it again.
Here comes the train. Choo-choo!
Miss Rabbit is the train driver.
All aboard!
Hooray! Clickety-clack, clickety-clack, the train is on the track. Half a puff, half a puff, clickety-clickety-clack.
Uh-oh. Here are your activity sheets.
Ooh. The children have to spot everything that is on the activity sheet.
A boat.
A signal box.
And a tunnel.
I can see trees.
Are trees on the list?
No. I can see clouds.
Are clouds on the list?
No.
I can see Grandad Dog.
Ahoy there!
Hello, Grandad Dog!
Is Grandad Dog on the list?
Silly Peppa. My Grandad won't be on the list.
But he is sailing a boat.
And a boat is on the list.
Hooray!
The children tick the boat on their activity sheets.
Tickets, please.
Mr. Rabbit has come to check everyone's ticket.
I think I've lost my ticket.
Oh, dear, oh, dear.
Meow.
There's your ticket, Pedro.
You were sitting on it.
Now you try not to lose it again, Pedro. The train is going slowly uphill. The train is going quickly downhill.
Madam Gazelle, I feel a bit sick. Can I go to the front, please?
OK, Pedro. You can go to the front of the train.
Do-da-dum-dum-da-dee-da.
Nay.
Hello, Pedro. Not feeling very well. Would you like to drive the train for a bit?
Yes, please.
Clickety-clack, clickety-clack, the train runs on the track. Huff
and puff,
huff and puff, the train runs on the track.
A signal box. That's on our list.
Hooray!
The children tick the signal box on their activity sheets. The signal has stopped the train so that someone important can cross.
It's Mrs. Duck and her friends.
Oh, we still haven't seen a tunnel.
Oh, it's gone dark.
We're in a tunnel.
The tunnel is the last thing on the activity sheet.
Hooray!
Last stop!
Wall change! Everybody off now.
But, Madam Gazelle, how are we going to get home?
Oh, Peppa, we are back where we started.
The train has gone in a big circle.
Tickets, please.
Pedro's lost his ticket again.
Pedro, can I have my hat back, please?
There's Pedro's ticket.
Oh, that's where I put it. The fire engine.
Mummy Pig is dressed as a fireman.
Mummy, why are you dressed like that?
I'm going to the Mummy's fire engine practice.
Ooh.
Oh, it's just a good excuse for a cup of tea and a chat.
Well, what are you doing today, Daddy Pig?
I've got a very important meeting with the Daddy's football team.
That's just a lot of grown-up boys kicking a football around.
We're having a barbecue as well.
Here are Mr. Bull, Mr. Rabbit, Mr. Pony and Mr. Zebra.
Moo! Is Steady Pig coming out to play?
Come on!
Mummy, can we see the fire engine?
Yes.
Oh, goody!
This is Miss Rabbit's fire station.
Hello, Pepper and George. Come and see the fire engine.
Wow!
Fire engine!
There's a ladder for climbing, a hose for squirting water, and a big bell to ring.
Ding dong, ding dong.
Now, let's go up the tower and look for fires.
Hello, everyone.
Hello, Peppa.
Hello, George.
Oh, who's for a nice cup of tea and a chat?
That sounds nice.
Ooh, a telephone.
Peppa, that is the fire phone. It's only to be used when there's a fire.
Ah! Fire! Fire!
Fire station! Where's the fire? Where's the fire?
Can I speak to Mummy Pig, please?
Oh, it's Daddy Pig.
Daddy Pig! You're not supposed to ring on this phone. It's only for emergencies.
This is an emergency. I can't find the tomato ketchup anywhere.
Daddy Pig, shall I light the barbecue now?
Yes, please, Mr. Rabbit.
Do be careful with the barbecue, Daddy Pig.
Trust me, Mummy Pig. We daddies know all about barbecues. Bye.
Maybe it needs more charcoal.
Give it a bit of a blow.
Put a few more fire lighters on.
Now, we just have to wait for a fire.
How long do we have to wait?
Oh, it could be a long time. I've been waiting ages.
How many fires have you actually put out, Miss Rabbit?
None. Not one fire. But you've got to be ready.
It's the fire phone.
Oh, can you answer it, Peppa? It'll probably be your daddy again.
OK. Hello, fire station.
Hello, Peppa.
Oh, Daddy, it is you.
You're very naughty. This phone is for fires only.
Can you put Miss Rabbit on, please? There's a good girl.
Daddy wants to speak to you.
Hello, Daddy Pig. This phone is only to be used when there's a...
Fire! Fire!
Oh, dear. Daddy Pig's barbecue is on fire.
Fire! Fire!
Mummy's to the rescue!
Whee!
Whee! Hold tight.
Whee!
Whee!
It's Miss Rabbit's fire engine.
Stand back, Daddies!
Mummy Dog, turn on the water.
Aye, aye, Mummy Pig.
The fire is out.
Hooray! Thank you for saving us, Miss Rabbit.
No problem. It's all part of the service.
The Mummy's Fire Engine Service.
And now that Miss Rabbit has kindly flooded our garden, we can all jump up and down in muddy puddles.
Yes!
I love fire engines, especially when they make muddy puddles. Princess Peppa.
It is bedtime for Peppa and George.
Good night, my little piggies.
Granny and Grandpa Pig have come for dinner.
Hello.
Hello.
Where are Peppa and George?
They're asleep.
Oh, but I so wanted to see them. Can I take a peek?
OK, Granny Pig, but be very quiet.
Granny Pig!
Granny Pig!
Hello, my little darlings. You should be asleep.
Tell us a story.
OK, but only if you promise to go straight back to sleep.
We'll go to sleep after the story.
All right. Once upon a time, there was...
a little boy called Pedro Pony, and he found a magic bean.
Oh, yes. Now, Pedro planted that bean, and it grew into an enormous beanstalk that went high into the sky.
That's right.
Pedro climbed to the top of that beanstalk and found a...
horrible big giant. But I don't want that. I want a princess.
Oh, yes. There he found a beautiful Princess Peppa. And Sir George, the brave knight.
And a cook who makes the most delicious food ever.
Mummy Pig, Daddy Pig and Grandpa Pig are waiting to eat dinner.
I'll go and see what's keeping Granny Pig.
What's next in the story?
Naughty Granny Pig. You woke the little ones.
We promise to sleep when the story ends, Grandpa.
I'm good at ending stories, Granny Pig. You go downstairs. I won't be long.
There's a boy, a beanstalk, a beautiful princess, a brave knight, and a cook who makes a lovely dinner.
Well, after they ate the lovely dinner, everyone fell asleep. The end.
Then they all woke up and along came a wizard.
A wizard?
Yes, a wizard who is going to do a big magic show.
Ah, but...
then along came a scary dragon.
Granny Pig, Mummy Pig and Daddy Pig are still waiting to eat dinner.
That bedtime story doesn't seem to be working.
I'm the expert at telling bedtime stories. I'll have them asleep in no time.
A scary dragon!
Peppa, George, back to bed.
But Grandpa, hasn't finished the story yet, Daddy.
I'll finish the story. I'll be down in a minute.
Okay. There's a boy, a beanstalk, a castle, a beautiful princess, a brave knight, a cook, a wizard, and a scary dragon.
And a very hungry king. So they all had a big dinner and lived happily ever after. The end.
Then they had a party. And all their friends came.
Right, I think I'd better sort this out. Daddy Pig.
They're almost asleep.
Thank you. I'll take over now.
You have to finish the story, Mummy.
All right, quickly now. Tell me what's happened.
Once upon a time, in olden days, a long time ago...
Mummy Pig's been up there for a long time.
I can hear snoring.
At last, Pepper and George are asleep.
And then they all lived happily ever after. The end.
Pepper? George?
Shush! Mummy is asleep.
It looks like Princess Pepper is the best at telling bedtime stories.
That's right. I am.